So Bede, in this chapter, you have started with the covalent bond, the bond which is formed by sharing of the electrons, neither gain nor lose. Okay? And this chapter is related to carbon. So carbon in its valence shell, it has four electrons. You know? You know, in the first shell, it is two, and second shell, there are four electrons of the carbon. Now, if it will gain four electrons, it will form C4 negative and six proton inside the nucleus can't hold 10 electrons. Okay? It is very difficult for the six proton to hold now 10 electrons. After gaining four electrons, it is very difficult for the six proton to hold the 10 electron. So it can't gain four extra electrons. In the same way, it can't lose four electrons. It can't lose four electrons to form C4 positive. Why? To remove four electrons from the carbon, we need so much of energy that is known as ionization enthalpy or energy. And nucleus, you are aware that nucleus is having six protons. And these six protons are very much holding the six electrons. So you can remove one, two electrons, it is easier. But to remove four electrons from an atom, it's very difficult. Theek? So how does the carbon complete its octet? It can complete the octet by shearing, by forming covalent bond. Okay? How does the covalent bond can be formed? It can be formed with the carbon itself or another atom. Like for example, we usually do the example of methane. You know? So carbon in the valence shell is having these four electrons. Now it has to complete its octet. It has to complete the octet, so it will shear. Will definitely shear. Okay? It will shear. How it will shear? With hydrogen, with oxygen, with nitrogen, any of the atom. So this is the chapter related to hydrocarbons. So let us start with the shearing of hydrogen. So each hydrogen is having one electron. Okay? In its valence shell. So, in case of like methane, these carbon electrons, which are four in number, is being shared by hydrogen, each of the hydrogen, forming four covalent bonds. One, two, three, and four. Okay? In this way, doublet of hydrogen and octet of carbon is also complete. And thus forming four covalent bonds. Okay? The bond which is formed by shearing is known as covalent bond. Like I have taken the example of methane as you are dealing with the chapter hydrocarbon. In the same way, I can give the example of only hydrogen. See, you know, in the hydrogen, the last shell, the valence shell, is having only one electron. And in that shell, there can be two electrons. Okay? हाइड्रोजन के पास होते ही वन इलेक्ट्रॉन और उसमें दो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आ सकते हैं. ठीक, तो आपने हर एक हाइड्रोजन क्या करता है, इट विल शेयर द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, इट विल शेयर द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स द वैलेंस शेल एंड दस फॉर्मिंग अ सिंगल कोवलेंट बॉन्ड. सी, ईच कोवलेंट बॉन्ड इज हैविंग बेटे वन टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ईच कोवलेंट बॉन्ड इज हैविंग टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. So hydrogen will have single covalent bond to form H2. Karan Jyoti is also joining today. Okay? Okay. So likewise, oxygen, talking about oxygen, bete, oxygen has atomic number of 8. In the valence shell, it is having 6 electrons. Okay? Talking about oxygen, it is having atomic number 8. So The first shell there are two electrons, and in the second shell there are six electrons. So to complete the octet, an oxygen need two electrons. Definitely it can take two electrons from another atom. It's very easy for oxygen to form oxide O2 negative. But what about two oxygen atoms? As they have same power, so they can't abstract two electrons from each other. Okay? They can take from a metal like sodium. Sodium can give two electrons to oxygen to form ionic bond. But when we are talking about only oxygen and forming O atom, say O oxygen, O2 molecule, it is formed by the sharing of the electron. Theek? So how much electron does it need? It needs two electrons. So it will form two covalent bonds. Theek? So it is doubly bonded molecule. Like each oxygen is having six electron in the valence shell. Okay, bete. Six electron in the valence shell. To complete the octet, each oxygen need two electrons. So two electrons are being shared by each of the oxygen. So total here eight electrons are there. Here also there are eight electrons. And thus oxygen is forming how many bonds? It is forming double bond. Theek? With each other. As both the oxygen atom has same power, we can say same ionization enthalpy, same electron gain enthalpy, the terms are used. But if oxygen is being attached to a metal, definitely it will gain two electrons. Okay? Likewise, between nitrogen, you are knowing that nitrogen is having short of three electrons. Okay? Nitrogen, jo 2,5 hai. Having atomic number 7. So nitrogen, definitely nitrogen, which is having atomic number 7 and have 5 electrons in the valence shell, can gain the electrons from another atom to form N3 negative. This called nitride, we kehte ho na. It is sodium nitride. Hai na? So aise hi wo gain kar sakta hai. But in case of if nitrogen is attached to other nitrogen, how it will complete the octet? It will complete the octet by forming triple bond. Na? Because each nitrogen wants to have three electrons to complete its octet. So each nitrogen will be giving their three electrons and sharing with other nitrogen to form triple bond. So these are 5 electrons of this nitrogen, and these are 5 electrons of this nitrogen, and it will form a triple bond. Thus we say that nitrogen with other nitrogen forming N2 have triple bond. Okay? It will be having triple bond. Getting the point? See, the chapter is so much small. We know that what will come in the exam. They can say you to draw the electron dot diagrams. They can ask you about the nature of the carbon, that is tetravalency and the catenation properties. Else the chapter is nothing now. No reaction is there in your syllabus. Okay? Okay? Likewise, if we have to draw the fluorine, how you will draw the fluorine? Okay, how you will draw the fluorine? Now, fluorine is having atomic number 9. Each fluorine atom has the electronic configuration, this 2,7, 2,7. Now each fluorine atom wants one electron to complete its octet. So they will share only one electron. And rest of the 7, this is 6 electron are like this only. we are not talking about this shell, we are talking about only the valence shell. So in the electron dot diagram, we are only drawing the electrons available in the valence shell, not in the previous shell. Okay, it is called valence bond theory. The valence shell electrons participate in the bonding, not the inner one. Okay, now come bete the next topic of your chapter, that is versatile nature of the carbon. Now carbon can form number of compounds, million trillions of compounds, because of two properties. Okay, so versatile nature of carbon. Okay, so carbon can form a number of compounds because of two properties. One is tetravalency, and one is catenation. Now, what is tetravalency? Tetravalency is nothing to form four bonds. As carbon is deficient of four electrons, so at a time it can form four bonds. As it has valence, four electrons. ठीक है? तो four bonds बना सकता है. Four bonds किसके साथ बना सकता है? Four bonds carbon खुद carbon के साथ बना सकता है. फोर बॉन्ड किसके साथ बनाएगा? फोर बॉन्ड हाइड्रोजन के साथ बना सकते हैं. ठीक है, फोर बॉन्ड किसके साथ बना सकता है? फोर बॉन्ड्स एट ए टाइम, जैसे ऑक्सीजन है तो एट ए टाइम टू बॉन्ड्स बनाने हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल अगर टू बॉन्ड्स बनाए हैं तो हम यहाँ पे टू हाइड्रोजन और दिखा देंगे, कुछ भी. ठीक है, यू हैव डन डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ फंक्शनल ग्रुप. इवन सिंगल बॉन्ड भी बना सकते, तो देन ऑक्सीजन विल फॉर्मिंग हियर इन अनदर बॉन्ड. ओके, बट एट ए टाइम इट विल फॉर्म इन फोर बॉन्ड्स. दिस बॉन्ड्स कैन बी फॉर्म बिटवीन कार्बन कार्बन, कार्बन हाइड्रोजन, कार्बन नाइट्रोजन, कार्बन सल्फर टू, क्लोरीन, ऑक्सीजन, हैलोजन, जो मर्जी ले लो, सबके साथ बन सकता है. ठीक है, ओके. इसके अलावा द कार्बन में सेकंड प्रॉपर्टी क्या है बेटे? कैटिनेशन. कैटिनेशन इज सेल्फ लिंकिंग प्रॉपर्टी. ठीक है, कार्बन कैन कंबाइन विद अनदर कार्बन. ठीक है, इट हैज सेल्फ लिंकिंग, मींस अपने आप से लिंक होना, सेल्फ लिंकिंग प्रॉपर्टी. Okay, now when it is self-linked, it can link in the form of chain. The chain can be straight chain, it can be branch chain. Okay, even there it can be rings too. Rings ban sakti hain, jaise marzi ring bana lo, jitne marzi carbon atom ki. So many rings you can draw with the branches also. So you can form rings, you can form double bond, you can form triple bond. So when double and triple bond comes, we say that they are unsaturated hydrocarbon. And when there are single bond present between two carbon atom, these are saturated or alkenes. When there come double bond between two carbon atom, we say it alkene or unsaturated. ठीक है बेटे? So carbon has a unique property to self link with another carbon to form long chain, branch, rings. ठीक है, तो the bonds may be single, double, triple. If there is a single bond, it is known as saturated. These are alkanes. And if there are double or triple bond, they are unsaturated. These are alkene or alkyne. Okay. Got it? Yes, with any doubt till here, you can ask. Any doubt? No doubt? So you are all aware of this, okay? Then, Betty, let us talk about saturated and unsaturated carbon atoms. Okay, Betty. So there are hydrocarbons. What are organic compounds? They are hydrocarbon and its derivatives. Okay, there are hydrocarbon and its derivatives. Derivatives जब हम hydrogen के अलावा कोई और functional group लेके आते हैं. अगर हम बात करें hydrocarbon की, तो these are two type बेटे. One is saturated and other one is unsaturated. As the name itself clear to you, that is unsaturated, you can't add anything, and in unsaturated you can add something. Okay, in saturated you can only do the substitution. You can remove an hydrogen and you can add another thing. Okay, but in unsaturated, this type of compound undergo addition reaction. In the saturated one, only alkanes come. Okay, alkanes. In the unsaturated one, it comes alkene and alkynes. In alkanes, there is a single bond present between the carbon atom. Okay, in case of alkene, there is double bond between the two carbon atoms, and in alkyne there is a triple bond present between two carbon atoms. Okay, so it is a single bond, then here is a double bond, and here there is a triple bond. Okay, so we have already done the nomenclature. Like if you are having one carbon atom, it is known as meth, so it will be methane. If two, that is eth, that is ethane, and if you have three, that is prop, that is propane. Likewise, this is methane. Okay, this is ethane, so on. This is propane, and so on, bete. And in these two carbon atom, if there is a double bond, that is known as ethene. And if there is a triple bond between the carbon atom, it is known as ethyne. Okay, so it is known as bete ethyne. Getting my point? So likewise, you have drawn the electron dot diagram. You have to draw the electron dot diagram of these compound also, like ethane, ethene, and ethyne. It's very important for the exams. So let us draw this. See. Now in case of ethane, there is carbon, single bond carbon, and there are three hydrogen attached. After drawing the bonds between two carbon atoms, you will complete the valency by giving them hydrogen atom. Like this carbon is having one bond, and so we have completed its valency by placing three hydrogen. Okay? Now these carbon, in case of ethene, they are already having two bond, means divalency is complete. So two more hydrogen they want to complete the tetravalency. Okay, likewise, this, in case of ethyne, these two carbon is having triple bond, and if you want to complete valency, you will add one more hydrogen. Okay, now from here you can draw the electron dot diagram too. Like carbon having one two, three, four electrons, and this carbon is also having one, two, three, four electrons, and this electron is of hydrogen. Again, hydrogen, hydrogen. Okay, now you have to complete eight electrons around each carbon atom. So you will draw like this to complete the eight electrons and showing all the bonds around the carbon. In the same way, you will show here. And each hydrogen is having a single bond, forming of two electrons. Okay. In the same way, you can draw ethene. So there are double bond. The double bond के लिए मैंने यहाँ पे दिखा दिए. There is a single bond. There is again single bond. You can even draw like this if you want to draw, like here also. Here, like here. This is hydrogen, this is hydrogen, this is hydrogen, and this is hydrogen. And here, eight electrons are completed. Here, eight electrons. Even you can draw a petty dot here to show the electron of the hydrogen. But actually, when the molecule is formed by overlapping of the electron cloud, no one can distinguish the electron, whose electron is which one. Okay, so you can draw the crosses also, and you can draw the dot also. It's your wish. हाँ जी, likewise you can draw बेटे ethyne. So draw yourself, hurry up. Draw ethyne. Yes, when you will draw, then let me know. Hurry up. Hurry up, bete. Just draw it. You have done. Aditi has done. Other. Arshin has done. Hanji, bas. Two students have done. Else they're all sleeping in their quilts. Imani has done. Ankita, Diksha. चलो now इसके बाद हमने hydrocarbons के बारे में जाना था बेटे. Hydrocarbon में alkane के बारे में. If it is a single carbon, then word root is meth, and as it is alkane, the suffix is ane. It is methane. Likewise, the next one is, we are doing only straight chain alkanes in case of class 10. So this is ethane. Now three carbon atoms. See बेटे, आपने हाइड्रोजन पूरे करने होते हैं ना, तो आपने कैसे करने हैं? आपने सिर्फ, मैंने पहले भी बताया कि एक बॉन्ड ऑलरेडी है, तो इट नीड थ्री हाइड्रोजन. ठीक है, फोर बॉन्ड्स पूरे करने. यहाँ पे कितने हैं? टू बॉन्ड्स ऑलरेडी हैं, तो इसके पास टू हाइड्रोजन होने चाहिए. ठीक है, यहाँ पे भी वन है, तो यू कैन ड्रॉ लाइक, चलो आई एम ड्रॉइंग लाइक दिस, यू कैन ड्रॉ थ्री हाइड्रोजन. ठीक है, इट इज प्रोपेन. इन द सेम वे, वन टू थ्री फोर. तो इसके पास एक बॉन्ड ऑलरेडी है, तो हमने थ्री हाइड्रोजन दे दिए. इसके पास टू है, तो टू और दे दिए. इसके पास टू है, तो टू और दे दिए. और इसको हमने दे दिए बेटे थ्री. ओके, सो दिस इज ब्यूटेन. ओके, सो दिस इज ब्यूटेन. लाइक दैट दिस इज पेंटेन. every time one CH2 group increases, every time ये homologous series भी है, ठीक है, homologous series है जिसमें एक ही type of functional group है जो कि alkane है, और हर एक जस्ट ये दोनों को छोड़ के इसके बाद जो start होता है बेटे उसमें एक CH2 group increase हो रहा है। देखो CH2 यहाँ पे एक आ गया, फिर आप यहाँ पे एक और आ गया, then one more CH2 group is there, तो CH2 group is coming again and again at every successive member, ठीक है, likewise row hexane, hurry up, row hexane increase one CH2 group more, so you will get hexane. These are straight chain alkane. Likewise, you can form a cyclic, like six membered CH2 and CH2. Okay, so this is cyclohexane, that is a six member. Okay, so ab yes, triangle, you're right. So CH2. This is cyclohexane. See, when there is alternate double bond between, this is single bond, then here is a double bond. Okay, then there is a single bond, then there is a double bond. Okay, then there is a single bond and then there is a double bond. Now this kind of a structure is known as benzene. ठीक है बेटे, this kind of a structure it is not known as cyclotriene. As you will do in higher standard, it is involved in the resonance. So it is not known as cyclotriene कि तीन triple bond, it is known as benzene. इसकी वैलेंसी कैसे कंप्लीट करोगे, देखो हर एक कार्बन के पास ऑलरेडी थ्री बॉन्ड हैं, तो यू हैव टू गिव वन हाइड्रोजन एक्स्ट्रा ऑन, ठीक है, सो हियर इज अ वन हाइड्रोजन, वन टू थ्री बॉन्ड्स ऑलरेडी है इसके पास भी वन टू थ्री हैं, तो वन हाइड्रोजन इन द सेम वे, वन टू थ्री अगेन यू विल गिव वन हाइड्रोजन, वन टू थ्री अगेन यू विल गिव वन हाइड्रोजन अगेन एंड अगेन, ठीक है, ओके, ये एक सारा स्ट्रक्चर हमने दिखा दिया, इसको ऐसे भी दिखा सकते हो, दिस अंडरस्टूड कि ये जो एजेस है ये कार्बन है, इट इज वेरी मच अंडरस्टूड, ये एजेस जो है बेटे कार्बन है, और देन यू कैन शो द बॉन्ड्स लाइक दिस, एक्चुअली दीज बॉन्ड्स आर ऑलवेज एंड ऑलवेज रिवॉल्विंग लाइक दिस, दैट इज नोन एज रेजोनेंस. So we draw like this circle showing the bonds are always exchanging the position. Okay, this phenomenon is known as resonance, and it is not necessary in bond line structure to show the carbon atom and show the hydrogen atom. Okay, this is called a bond line. In the same way, if I want to draw hexane, I will draw like this. This is one carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is also hexane. This is called bond line, है ना? तो इसमें ये जो edges होती हैं ये carbon है. और it is understood कि इसकी valency complete है. तो कितने edges देखो? 1 carbon, 2 carbon, 3, 4, 5, 6. इसे hexane बोलोगे. ऐसे अगर मैं ऐसे करके ऐसे बना दूँ, तो there are 1, 2, 3, 4. तो ये butane है. ठीक है, इन द सेम वे अगर मैं ऐसे साइकिल बना दूं अकेला ऐसे, तो ये साइक्लोहेक्सेन है. इट इज बिट अंडरस्टूड कि ये कार्बन बता रहा है आपको. गॉट इट? सो टाइम इज गोइंग टू बी अप एंड आवर चैप्टर इज आल्सो कवर्ड, देयर विल बी अनदर चैप्टर इज कवर्ड, टुमारो विल डू एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चन आंसर. ओके, सो आप भी अपनी तरफ से रिवाइज करके आओगे.